हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू फ्रेंड्स? माय टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे इज सिक्स डिटरमिनेशन, वेयर यू विल स्टडी सिक्स डिटरमिनेशन इन ड्रोसोफिला एंड एनवायरमेंटल सिक्स डिटरमिनेशन. सो दीज टू इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स आई हैव कवर्ड इन दिस लेक्चर. So first of all, subscribe and share my channel. Drosophila melanogaster, actually it is commonly known as fruit fly. And although both mammals and fruit flies produce double X females and XY males, and the way in which their chromosomes achieve these ends are very different. In mammals, as you know very well, that Y chromosome play a pivotal role in determining the male sex, but in Drosophila, the Y chromosome is not involved in determining sex. In flies, the Y chromosome seems to be a collection of genes that are active in forming sperm in adult, but not in sex determination. A fruit fly's sex is determined predominantly by the number of X chromosomes in each cell. And if there is only one X chromosome in a diploid cell, the fly is male. If there are two X chromosomes in a diploid cell, the fly is female. Should a fly have two X chromosome and three sets of autosomes, it is a mosaic where some of the cells are male and some of the cells are female. Therefore, while XO mammals are sterile females, no Y chromosome, therefore no SRY gene. XO Drosophila are sterile males, one X chromosome per diploid set. In Drosophila and in insect in general, as you can say, one can observe gynandromorphs. What are gynandromorphs? That is animals in which certain regions of the body are male and other regions are female. These are known as gynandromorphs. Gynandromorphs fruit flies result when an X chromosome is lost from one embryonic nucleus. The cells descended from that cell, instead of being double X female, are XO male. The XO cells display male characteristics, whereas double X cells display female traits, suggesting that in Drosophila, each cell makes its own sexual decision. In 1919, Morgan and Bridges, these two very famous scientists, concluded that male and female parts and their sex-linked characters are strictly self-determined, each developing according to its own aspiration, and each sexual decision is not interfered with by the aspirations of its neighbors, nor is it overruled by the action of the gonads. Although there are organs that are exception to this rule, notably external genitalia, it remains a good general principle of Drosophila sexual development. Now, the explanation of these two pictures, the right side picture, this one, first picture, these two pictures shows gynandromorph insect. This first picture shows Drosophila melanogaster, in which left side is female, that is a double X, and right side is male XO, this one. The male side has lost an X chromosome bearing the wild type alleles of eye color and wing shape, thereby allowing expression of the recessive allele eosine I and miniature wing on the remaining X chromosome. The second picture shows bird wing butterfly Ornithopera croesus. The smaller male half is red, black and yellow, while the female half is larger and brown. This is the explanation of the gynandromorph insects. Now, sex lethal gene. Actually, it had long been thought that the fruit fly sex was determined by X to autosome, that is X is to A autosome ratio, according to Bridges in 1925. This assessment was based largely on flies with aberrant number of chromosomes. Recent molecular analysis suggests that X chromosome number alone is the primary sex determinant in normal diploid insects. The X chromosome contains genes encoding transcription factors that activate the critical gene in Drosophila sex determination. The X-linked locus sex lethal, that is SXL. So SX is L is sex lethal. The sex lethal protein is a splicing factor that initiates a cascade of RNA processing events that will eventually lead to male-specific and female-specific transcription factors. These transcription factors, the double-sex proteins, then differentially activate the genes involved to produce either the male phenotypes, that is testes, sex combs, pigmentation, or the female phenotype, that is ovaries, yolk proteins, pigmentation. Now, activating sex lethal, the number of X chromosomes appear to have only a single function, activating or not activating, and the early expression of sex lethal. So, SXL encodes an RNA splicing factor that will regulate gonad development and will also regulate the amount of gene expression from the X chromosome. The gene has two promoters, that is early promoter is active only in double X cells and later promoter is active in both double X and XY cells. The X chromosome appears to encode four protein factors that activate the early promoter of SXL. Three of these proteins are transcription factors. These are CISA, SISA, SCOOT, SCUTE, SCOOT, and RUNT, RUNT. So these factors bind to early promoter to activate transcription. But fourth protein, that is unpaired, is a secreted factor that reinforces the other three proteins through the JAK state pathway. If these factors accumulate so they are present in amounts above a certain threshold, the SXL gene is activated through its early promoters. The result is the transcription of SXL early in double X embryos during the syncytial blastoderm stage. The SXL pre-RNA transcribed from the early promoter of double X embryos lacks exon 3, which contain a stop codon. Therefore, SXL protein that is made early and spliced in a manner such that exon 3 is absent, so early double X embryos have complete and functional SXL protein. Now, in XY embryos, the early promoter of SXL is not active and no functional SXL protein is present. However, later in development, as cellularization is taking place, the late promoter becomes active and the SXL gene is transcribed in both males and females. In double X cells, SXL protein from the early promoter can bind to its own pre-mRNA and splice it in a female direction. In this case, SXL binds to and blocks the splicing complex on exon 3. As a result, exon 3 is skipped and not included in the SXL mRNA. Therefore, early production ensures that functional full-length 354 amino acid SXL protein is made if the cells are double X. In XY cells, however, the early promoter is not active because the X-encoded transcription factors have not reached the set threshold to activate the promoter, and there is no early SXL protein. Therefore, the SXL pre-messenger RNA of SXY cells is spliced in a manner that includes exon 3 and its terminating codon. Protein synthesis ends at the third exon after amino acid 48, and the SXL is non-functional. The picture explains the proposed regulatory cascade for Drosophila somatic sex determination. So, transcription factors from the X chromosomes activate SXL gene in females but not in male XY. So, the sex lethal protein perform three functions. Number one, it activate its own transcription, ensuring further SXL production. It represses the translation of MS12. So, this MS12 mRNA, a factor that facilitates transcription from the X chromosome, and this equalizes the amount of transcription from the two X chromosomes in females with that of single X chromosome in male. So, SXL enables the splicing of the transformer 1, that is TRA1 pre-mRNA, into functional proteins. The TRA proteins process double sex, that is DSX pre-mRNA, in a female specific manner that provides most of the female body with its sexual fate. They also process the fruitless pre-mRNA in a female specific manner, giving the fly female specific behavior. In the absence of SXL, and therefore the TRA proteins, DSX and fruitless pre-mRNA are processed in the male-specific manner. This right side picture shows the differential RNA splicing and sex-specific expression of sex lethal. In the syncytial blastoderm, this one of XX flies, transcription factors from the two XX chromosomes are sufficient to activate the early promoter of the SXL gene. This early transcript is spliced into an mRNA lacking exon 3, and this makes a functional SXL protein, right? The early promoter of XY flies is not activated, and males lack functional SXL. By the cellularizing blastoderm stage, the late promoter of SXL is active in both XX and XY flies. In XX flies, SXL already present in the embryo, which prevents the splicing of exon 3 into mRNA, and functional SXL protein is made. SXL then binds to its own promoter to keep it active. It also functions to splice downstream pre-mRNAs. In XY embryos, no SXL is present, and exon 3 is spliced into the mRNA. Because of the termination codon in exon 3, males do not make functional SXL. Now, targets of sex lethal. The protein made by the female-specific SXL transcript contain regions that are important for binding to rRNA. There appears to be three major RNA targets to which the female-specific SXL transcript bind. Number one, pre-mRNA of SXL itself. Second, MS12 gene that controls dosage compensation. Indeed, if the SXL gene is non-functional in a cell with two X chromosomes, the dosage compensation system will not work, and the result is the cell death, therefore gene's name. Number three is pre-mRNA of transformer TRA, the next gene in the cascade. The The pre-mRNA of transformers, so named because loss of function mutation turns female into male, is spliced into a functional mRNA by SXL protein. The tra-pre-mRNA is made in both male and female cells. However, in the presence of SXL, the tra-transcript is alternatively spliced to create a female specific mRNA as well as a non-specific mRNA that is found in both females and male. Like the male SXL message, the non-specific tra-mRNA message contains an early termination codon that renders the protein non-functional. Intra, the second exon of the non-specific mRNA contains the termination codon and is not utilized in the female-specific message. How is it that females and males make different mRNAs? The female-specific SXL protein activates a 3-splice site that causes tra-pre-mRNA to be processed in a way that splices out the second exon. To do this, SXL protein blocks the binding of splicing factor U2AF to the non-specific splice site of the tra message by specifically binding to the polypyrimidine tract adjacent to it. This causes U2AF to bind to the lower affinity female-specific 3' splice site and generate a female-specific mRNA. The female-specific tra protein works in concert with the product of the transformer 2, that is tra2 gene, to help generate the female phenotype by splicing the double sex gene in a female-specific manner. Now, double sex, that is the switch gene for sex determination, the Drosophila double sex B sex gene is active in both males and females, but its primary transcript is processed in a sex-specific manner. This alternative RNA processing is the result of the action of the TRA and TRA2 gene products on the DSX gene. If the TRA2 and female-specific TRA proteins are both present, the DSX transcript is processed in a female-specific manner. The female splicing pattern produces a female-specific protein that activates female-specific genes such as those of yolk protein and inhibits male development. If no functional TRA is produced, a male-specific DSX transcript is made. This transcript encodes a transcription factor that inhibits female traits and promotes male traits. In the embryonic gonad, DSX regulates all known aspects of sexually dimorphic gonad cell fate. In double X splice, the female double sex protein DSXF combines with the product of the intersex gene IX to make a transcription factor complex that is responsible for promoting female specific traits. This double sex complex activates the wingless WG gene, whose WNT family product promotes growth of the female portion of the genital disc. It also represses the FGF genes responsible for making male accessory organs, activates the genes responsible for making yolk proteins, promotes the growth of the sperm storage duct, and modifies BRCA-BRAC, that is BAB gene expression, to give the female specific pigmentation profile. In contrast, the male double sex protein, that is DSXM, acts directly as a transcription factor and directs the expression of male specific traits. It causes the male region of the genital disc to grow at the expense of the female disc region. It activates the BMP homolog, DPP in short, as well as stimulating FGF genes to produce the male genital disc and accessory structure. DSXM also converts certain cuticular structure into claspers and modifies the BRCA-BRAC gene to produce the male pigmentation pattern. Now, according to this model, the result of the sex determination cascade comes down to the type of mRNA processed from the double sex transcript. If there are two X chromosomes, the transcription factors activating the early promoter of SXL reach a critical concentration. The SXL makes a splicing factor that causes the transformer gene transcript to be spliced in a female-specific manner. This female-specific protein interacts with the TRO2 splicing factor, causing DSX pre-mRNA to be spliced in a female-specific manner. If the DSX transcript is not acted on in this way, it is processed in a default manner to make the male-specific message. Interestingly, the double-sex gene of flies is very similar to the DMRT1 gene of vertebrates, and the two types of sex determination may have some common denominators. Now, this is the explanation of this picture. This picture shows the sex-specific RNA splicing in four major Drosophila sex-determining genes. So, the pre-mRNA shown in this center of the diagram, these are identical to both male and female nuclei. This is. And in each case, the female-specific transcript is shown at the left, while the default transcript, whether male or non-specific, is shown to the right one here. So, exons are numbered and the position of terminating codon are marked. Sex lethal, transformer and double sex, these are all parts of genetic cascade of primary sex determination. The transcription pattern of fruitless determines the secondary characteristic of courtship behavior. This is all about the sex determination in Drosophila. Now, environmental sex determination. So, it's very important part. And in many organisms, sex is determined by environmental factors. For example, temperature, location, and presence of other members of the species. While the sex of most snakes and lizards is determined by sex chromosome at the time of fertilization, the sex of most turtles and all species of crocodilian is determined after fertilization by the embryonic environment. In these reptiles, the temperature of the eggs during a certain period of development is the deciding factor in determining sex. Small changes in temperature can cause dramatic changes in the sex ratio. Often, eggs incubated at low temperatures produce one sex, whereas eggs incubated at higher temperatures produce the other. There is only a small range of temperatures that permits both males and females to hatch from the same brood of eggs. So, the picture this shows on the right side, the abrupt temperature induced change in sex ratios for the red eared slider turtle. If a brood of eggs is incubated at a temperature below 28 degrees centigrade, all the turtles hatching from the eggs will be male. Whereas above 31 degrees centigrade, every egg gave rise to a female. At temperature in between, the brood gave rise to individual of both sex. Sexes variation on this theme also exists. For example, the eggs of the snapping turtle Macrochlamys become female at either cool 22 degrees centigrade or lower, or hot 28 degrees centigrade or above temperatures, and between these extremes, males predominate. Best studied example is European pond turtle Orbicularis, and in laboratory studies, incubating Emys eggs at temperature above 30 degrees centigrade produces all females, whereas temperature below 25 degrees centigrade produces all male broods. The threshold temperature at which the sex ratio is even is 28.5 degrees centigrade. The developmental window during the sex determination occurs can be discovered by incubating eggs at the male producing temperature for a certain amount of time and then shifting them to an incubator at the female producing temperature and vice versa. In Emys, the middle third of the development appears to be the most critical for sex determination, and it is believed that the turtles cannot reverse their sex after this period. Now, expression of the sex determining genes SOX9 and SRY in males and beta catenin in females are seen to correlate with male or female producing temperature. However, it is not known whether these genes are the temperature sensitive components of sex determination. Recently, genetic studies on the sensitivity of temperature induced sex determination have pointed to CIRBP, that is cold-induced RNA binding protein. CIRBP, cold-induced RNA binding protein, as the agent responding to temperature differences. The gene for CIRBP is expressed at the time of sex determination in snapping turtles, and different alleles give different sex ratio biases. This protein may act by repressing the splicing or translation of certain messages at certain temperatures. Another temperature sensitive protein that may regulate sex determination is TRPV4, a calcium channel whose activity correlates with activating testis forming genes. The mechanism of environmentally induced sex determination have yet to be elucidated. So this side picture shows the temperature dependent sex determination in 3 species of reptiles: the American alligator, alligator mississippiensis, red eared slider turtle, that is Trachymis scripta aliens, and alligator snapping turtle, that is Macrochelymus taming pie. So this is all about environmental sex determination as well as sex determination in Drosophila. Thank you very much. Like and subscribe my channel.